Ja, en bij mij aangeschoven veelgeprezen acteur, opera-regisseur en theatermaker Simon McBurney. Hij staat op het Holland Festival met een zeer enthousiast ontvangen solovoorstelling, The Encounter, die eerder zelfs bezocht is door Brad Pitt en Angelina Jolie. Welcome, Simon. We're very honored to have you here tonight. This book you read like 20 years ago.
That's right.
Yeah, what attracted you in the story?
Well, because it's a man who is lost. He's lost in the Amazon forest, but if you like, the forest is also the forest of our mind. And as somebody who is permanently lost, I'm interested in a story about people being lost. So
this was a good example.
This is a very good example. You know, it's about so many different things. It's about time, it's about death, it's about the fact, the nature of our culture, the culture that we live in. It's an extraordinary story, so you can get caught up in the story. What's going to happen? Is he going to live? Because he gets lost deep in the jungle. He encounters these incredible people, his extraordinary experiences. It's very violent, but at the same time, it is strangely about us. How do we relate to things that are outside of us? And that could also be because things that happened to him inside his head as well as physically. So
yes,
the dangers to him are not just actually physical things about whether he's going to live or
but
die, it's psychologically. Yeah.
Yeah. So this, did you know right away that you wanted to make a theater out of it?
No, I had no idea. In fact, I thought it was impossible.
Yes.
Because, I mean, how do you represent the most biodiverse place on earth if you're in the theater? What are you going to paint a little bit of jungle and have somebody come in on it, you know, like this? I don't know.
Yes.
You know, and you're going to have people play the Mayaruna? Well, of course not. That's embarrassing, you know, that's terrible. That's not what it's about. But it became clear to me that it was about a singular experience, about our own individual. Ooh, there goes the microphone. About our own individual experience. And so I thought, well, how can you make an audience feel something about being alone, given the fact that they're all here, like everybody here around this room?
Yes.
You know, how does everybody feel alone and together at the same time? And I wanted to isolate people. So I came up with an idea. I thought, you know, the best way to tell this story is just like to you and nobody else. But kind of telling it to one person is probably not such a good idea. You
know, not very common.
Yeah, it's kind of, you know, it's a rather expensive
yes
version of theatre. So I had this idea, well, what if everybody's hearing headphones? What if I do it all through microphones? Just as we watched a singer-songwriter just now, and I can't remember her name.
Effia.
Yeah, she was working with loop pedals and yeah all sorts of things. And I work in a similar kind of way, just with microphones. And I tell the story to people. But for everybody, it's a very different experience.
Yes.
And they listen to it through headphones, and that sounds really weird, or it sounds like a gimmick or anything like that, but it ends up that it's not really.
Okay, because we have a clip that shows a bit, maybe for the viewers at home, what it looks like, how we are in the theatre experiencing
okay
your theatre play. Let's have a look.
So if you put on your headphones, and if I were to breathe in your ear, your brain would tell you that I was really breathing in your ear, and it might even start to get hot.
He didn't speak to me. I think he spoke to me without words. Just as Barnacle undid my spell by running counterclockwise, I could be the crack between here and there. The crack through which another time, our time, might flood.
Yeah, we were just saying that's really difficult to tell the audience who haven't been to your show.
It's impossible.
What it's
I look
like
around the room, everyone's completely baffled.
But
what
I must
that
say, I was at the show a few days ago, and it's such an amazing experience because the headphones work so well. You hear all these sounds. It feels like you're really close. Sometimes the door opens and your daughter comes in to play, and it's just, even when your cell phone goes off, you think, who's having a cell phone with them?
That's because I use something called binaural sound.
Yes.
Which the easiest way to understand that is you get a 3D, a sense-around impression.
Yeah.
So with binaural sound, it's a head, and it imitates your head. So that if you stand behind the microphone over there, different to this microphone,
yeah,
this is just one direction, you can actually hear them in space. So one of the feelings is, for the audience, is when you have the jungle, as a consequence of this sound, they feel as if they really are within the jungle itself.
Yeah.
So in a sense, the audience go through the experience.